Marrakesh attracts over 2 million tourists a year, and people have a lot of choices in places to stay during their visit. I'm at the Meridian, which is very luxurious and has an amazingly beautiful garden. But I've also heard of Riad hotels as a popular option, and today I set out to visit some. There are two main sections in Marrakesh, one very old and the other very modern. Guelize is part of the French Quarter, and it feels very much like a European city. From the hotel, I pass by long boulevards, fountains, and shopping plazas before getting to the old Medina. We start our search in the North Medina, the birthplace of Riyadhs.
Hello.
Sophie is a French architect and the owner of Zawida 44.
Was this an older house beforehand, though?
Yes, it was an old house.
Oh, cool.
Yes, and a renovated.
Riyadhs are old Moroccan mansions with high walls, internal gardens, and usually fountains.
Very nice here. Now we're in the cinema room, and it's got this amazing ceiling. They found it, and they only had one little square of the painting, and they got a guy to recreate it across the entire ceiling. It's a very different kind of architecture. It's not really taking like the traditional Moroccan rooms and just touching it up. She redid most of it.
I head deeper into the Medina. Finding a specific address here is almost impossible.
So there's another one of the hand-painted signs for the Riad Yamma. So we're just gonna keep following those and we'll be there soon. Riad Yamma, right there. I walked right past it. It's funny.
Hey Abdul.
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
How are you? Well, welcome.
Thank you very much.
As you see, this is Hassan's art, some canvases, pictures, furniture.
Owned by artist and designer Hassan Hajjaj, this is a great place to relax and shop.
When I first learned about Hassan's work, it was actually through something similar to this. It was a show he had in New York with all these Marrakesh women on their motorcycles in these amazing clothes.
Here, I also meet Nicholas.
Oh, he has a Riad as well.
He has a Riad, yes.
In Marrakesh?
In Marrakesh, it's about 5 minutes away from.
Start to renovate it.
I get invited to see his place and take the opportunity. Even though it's close by, I'm glad to be guided there.
To bend your head?
I've never seen anything like this. Oh my god, look at the shower in the bath.
Riyadhs are designed to make you feel isolated from the outside world, and for a reason. In Islamic tradition, you aren't meant to show off your wealth. Windows face a central court instead of the street. and the house has a plain front so that people walking by never know what's inside.
I mean, I guess in Muslim country, because you have to hide your properties, yeah. So even if the whole are wearing jellabas, you never know if under the jellaba it's simple clothes or expensive clothes, and everyone looks the same because you have to be kind of discreet with what you have, with what you own.
Yeah, that's our way. I'm gonna move in.
To stay in a Riyadh, at first you can enjoy the architecture, which is really a part of Moroccan culture. And also, you really think like you're living with a family when you're staying in a Riyadh, and to enjoy the kitchen, to spend time to cook with the cook, and just to relax in this kind of real atmosphere. You can come into dining, massage room.
Oh my god.
And you can enjoy whatever massage. Even if outside when you're in the streets it's very noisy and busy because life is running around, and but inside it's really, really calm.
Yeah, it was amazing walking in here. There's a tiny little door and it's like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory almost.
Yeah, kind of.
You walk into the little door and then it's just the most amazing old architecture, beautiful colors. Yeah, I've never seen anything like it.
Some of the Riyadhs have the best restaurants in Marrakesh. It's my last night. At La Sultana, I have a meal that I will never forget.
So what we have here is a pigeon almond tart topped with cinnamon, all very Moroccan. I'm very excited, I've never had pigeon before. It's perfect, amazing. Many